Hey guys. So last week was the first time that I showed this painting robot in public. Thank you guys so much for your feedback. It was really interesting for me. The two most frequent questions that I got was, do you have any videos of the robot? And the second most frequent question was, can it go faster? What ended up happening when I was programming this robot at the very beginning was that I was playing with all kinds of variables at once to see what would work. And I was trying to create a piece that would then be entered into a painting competition. So there were a lot of limits with that, and I ended up finding a speed that worked and I stayed with it. I did find if I went faster, the paint wasn't being applied to the page, but I never really spent a lot of time figuring it out. So since you guys asked if it could go faster, I created this program where each brush stroke, it'll start at the motor speed of, I think, 4,000. Let me check. Okay, going through my code, it's gonna start at 4,500, and then it's gonna slowly, each brush stroke, incrementally get closer and closer to 30,000. So the reason I chose 30,000 was I just went through some blogs and found out that around 40,000, it really starts losing accuracy. And that this guy was limited to being at 30,000. So I've never run it more than 6,000. So I'm actually really nervous to see what happens and how hot this whole thing gets and if it starts spilling things. It will be speeding up the brush strokes as well as all the motions in the system. So currently the motions in the system include dipping the paintbrush. It also includes cleaning the paintbrush. So each time it goes and cleans the paintbrush, it's gonna get a little bit faster and a little bit faster. And I will bring the camera closer so you can see what's happening. Here we go. So it should be, and I forgot to mention before, it will be running the floral painting that I was doing throughout the crawl. So this is an example of what it was painting. There's also examples framed behind me. And it's always interesting to see this specific painting. Oh, it didn't run. One second. Oh, nice typo. Okay, now it should go. So it's always interesting painting the same thing over and over again with a robot because there's so many variables in the painting process that it's never the same twice. All right, here it goes. Okay, it should start with a red brush stroke. I'm just gonna make sure this is in the right position. And this should be a brush stroke at 4,500. Stroke number two. One thing I forgot to do was put in the code to tell me what the speed is at each brush stroke so then I could call it out. So we're a little bit blind here. I might change the code right now. So it's run four brush strokes. Let's change the code so we can do that. So what I do is I stop the robot and I'll take the first four brush strokes out of the CSV file. One, two, three, four. And I'll save it as version 2. Save. And now let's change the code. So I want to print out the robot speed. That way I can call out how fast it's going. I'm going to print robot speed just so I know what it's saying. Print the current robot speed is, and then it's a plus. And it should dip into the red. It's printing all the segments. It didn't like my code. Robot speed is, must be a string, not a float. So all I have to do is put str and brackets around robot speed and then it'll work. Okay, let's try this again. And this is why programming a robot takes so long. People often think that I'm taking away jobs, but this actually takes longer. So let's try this again. Paste, Python, paint, increase, speed.py. All right, here we go. So now it should be on the sixth brush stroke. It will dip in again. To the red, dip, and let's try this again. Ah, it didn't work. Oh, I didn't hit save. Wow, you guys have some patience if you're still watching. Probably edit this out. Robot speed is 4600. Robot speed. It's actually hard to find and print out. Robot speed is 18.75. All right, I'll move the camera so you guys can get a closer look. And we'll watch the robot speed increase. Robot speed is 6,604. Robot speed 6,666. Robot speed 6,728.
current robot speed is Right now the robot speed is 9,080. lose Carmen. The robot speed is currently 14,526. So it's over double right now than what I've tried before. The speed is currently 14,836. $15,207. The speed is currently, oh, it goes by faster now, it's harder to read. 15,888. the speed it will start up again is at 17,497. The speed is now 18,487. Thank you. So the speed is now 2300. Speed is 24,429. 28,700. The robot speed is now 28,824. Speed's currently 29,690. Unfortunately, that was a pretty uneventful movie. Hopefully other ones will have, you'll get to see the happy accidents that could happen during a robot painting. I'm actually pretty happy how that worked out. One of the things that I cut out of the video is there was a 7-minute pause between colors. And usually for the crawl, I only had 2 minutes and I wanted 7 just to make sure everything was really dry. And I'm glad I did that because the cycle started getting faster and faster, and so the paint was not drying at all. So a few things I did notice, and I wanted to stand over here so you could see the framed one of what I'm actually going for. So you can see that the brush strokes are much smaller, or I should say skinnier, on the one that's done at a slower speed versus the one that just painted. The initial brush strokes look the same as what we had before, but then as you get faster and faster, the brush strokes get bigger and bigger. So the flowers are done at the end, so you can see that it's a really dense brush stroke. Probably the most interesting brush stroke was around 30,000 for these final yellow ones, where you can see that that brush just went slam and then pulled across rather than nicely being placed onto the painting. What I did find interesting watching this happening is what an artist will usually do is their first brush strokes are very loose and it's just getting paint down, getting color down. And then as they get into more detail, or this is how I personally paint, as I get into more detail, then I pull out smaller brushes, but I also paint a lot slower. So in actuality, what would be more similar to how a human paints or how I paint is to have it go really fast at the beginning and then slow down at the end and make sure that those final brush strokes are placed very nicely. But I don't know why I'm painting so slow, and even if the brush strokes are bigger, what I can do is then just use a smaller brush to get the same point across. Yeah. Thanks guys for asking me about speed. I'm glad I tried this out. That's the outcome.
So if you have any other questions about my painting process with the robot or want to see me try something out, put it in the comments and I'll think about it and maybe I'll try it in my next video. But thanks so much for watching. Thanks for following my artwork. It's been a lot of fun getting a robot to paint because it makes me break down the painting process into little minute steps that then the robot can run, and it makes me a better painter, and it's also, robots are just fun. All right, see you next time. Thank you.